Hello and welcome back to Hypnosis Today, where we explore how people are using hypnosis to achieve remarkable things. If you've just joined us, I have as my very special second guests, Giannina Casarino. She's an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. She's in the dental health field as well as the mental health field. And she has with her her very special guest and client, Tracy. Now, Tracy came in to see Giannina, well, for having some anxiety while waiting for those medical test results to return. Please help me welcome my guests. Tracy, I want to start with you. Can you tell us what was going on?
Well, it was that time of the year again. I had to have my routine mammogram, and I got the call back, which I had had that before. And then I found out I had to have a biopsy, which turned out to be fine, but I was so stressed. And so I had G come and do some hypnotherapy on me. It was perfect timing. And I have to tell you that when I was stressed, I was at a level of such high stress for 2 days waiting for this secondary results that my glands were swollen, my side of my face got tender, and I had a rash on my forehead, and it was from the stress.
Well, that couldn't have helped to be waiting for test results to come back and to break out in unexplainable and scary symptoms. But you're talking to the right person. Right. You know, we believe in the mind-body connection. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this is a understandable and universal anxiety. What do you do when you have to have that biopsy and you're waiting for those tests to come back? Tell me what was going on in your mind and body.
It was, you know, I have to say that the doctor said, I mean, it's sort of a long story because I didn't get the initial test results right away because they were so busy. So that caused stress. And then my doctor said, oh, it's very, very small and chances are it'll be nothing. But still, it could be something, right? So I'm dealing with that whole thing. And then I thought, you know, the key, how do we deal with this kind of crisis is be in the moment. And how do we do that? And the hypnotherapy is one way that I found to really help me just be centered. And even though, you know, our surface mind says, oh, you know, you'll probably be okay and the statistics are this, what they're really looking at is, do you have cancer or not?
That's right.
And that was, it was a great experience for me, though, to go through it and to know that I'll be okay in the sense of having that center.
Exactly, because, you know, all the hypnotherapists out there, we know that the conscious mind has logic and reason. It says everything's going to be okay, but the subconscious mind has all those fears. There's those runaway thoughts like a train.
Exactly.
With this, I want to go to Giannina. Giannina, this is such a common anxiety. It's certainly understandable. And a lot of people say, well, you know what? This is just what we have to live through. Can you tell me, what did you do? What do you do with anybody who has this kind of anxiety when waiting for, well, the results of any test, medical or even the SATs, waiting for those results to come back?
Well, first of all, I want the client to know the power of their mind. So I use a physical induction, such as an arm raising, to get them to see that they've used their mind and their imagination to make their hand lift and rise. And when they see that, they know that they can use their imagination and their mind to create that sense of calm and eliminate their anxiety.
So Tracy, when you felt your hand lifting and rising, lighter and lighter, light as a feather, what was that like for you?
That was, I have to say, one word comes to mind, just plain cool.
Yes.
You know, because I could feel as she's talking to me, and there was a bit of my conscious mind thinking, okay, is my hand going to go up? Because I had been hypnotized one time a long time ago. But it was amazing. And it was just, I could just feel it go like that and just rise and rise. And it was very exciting.
So that brought the credibility for you.
Absolutely.
That something unusual is going on here.
Absolutely.
What next?
Next, I created a sense, a sacred space for the client, utilizing all their five senses, and I had them connect with their inner guide. In that space, I created an anchor with a deep breath that the client can manifest and create in a natural waking state.
Did you discover an inner guide?
I did.
What did your inner guide, what did that look like, feel
like? Well, you know, because we're talking about the guided, when you were mm-hmm. doing the guide. Okay, so when she did the liquid light coming through up from my feet all the way up, there's something about that liquid light, when you were describing that, I immediately felt so relaxed. And then we went through this part where I'm on the staircase, you know, and then I'm out in the garden, and yes, the guides that come, or it was one guide, but I didn't tell you this, I had like three. And I figured, that's fine. If they want to show up and be a group, I'll take it.
You had,
and it was really powerful.
Inner guides by committee. I like it.
Yes, it was a committee. So to this day, I still see, when I listen back, I still have my group.
What were your inner guides like? Did you recognize them?
You know what? I didn't recognize them. They were very kind of ethereal. I can see them right now. And they immediately made me feel calm and protected. And so they just all kind of they're kind of huddled together. I should have somebody sketch it.
You should sketch it.
Maybe, yeah. So they're like just all standing just together in this peaceful sort of like a U shape looking at me.
Well, you know, it's so interesting.
Robes and stuff, white robes.
Sounds beautiful. You know, you said someone should sketch it. I noticed that you brought something to show
us.
What did you bring us, Tracy?
Well, I call her G. G gave me this book when we started our sessions, and she had me write some affirmations. So I've been writing these affirmations, and again, it's another guide for me.
Why do affirmations work when you write them, Giannina? Come on, now, see, she's also one of my interns, so this is actually a test question. Why does writing affirmations work?
Because writing is an audiomotor response, and it connects the client to their subconscious mind. And what they're writing may be conscious, but the way they write, it seals it all in together.
Because that was my next question. Now you were able to feel the liquid light. You were able to access your inner guides by committee. Mm-hmm. How did that translate into a full waking state, knowing that any minute, or maybe not any minute, that phone was going to ring with your results? How did that translate into a full waking state?
And it's great, I can tell you so specifically. It calmed me down. I remember it was a Friday morning, and I still had to wait, you know, it was 1 month from the beginning to the end of this process for me. And so that's why this was so important, that I had this experience in the midst of it. I felt peaceful, but I have to tell you, physically, physiologically, this all went down within 3 days. So it went away, all of that. I mean, obviously it was from the stress.
Sure.
I've never had that happen before. So that all went away, and by the time I got the phone call that everything was fine, I really was calmer. And I also, it was such a good experience. I wouldn't trade the experience of going through that and then having the hypnotherapy, of course, because now I know how to deal with who knows what's next. You know, you never know. We just don't know.
So what other way are you going to use these tools in different parts of your life?
I think just as a daily tool, in just staying centered, because obviously we don't want to wait for the next crisis, because look, next year is the next mammogram, and that's just the way it goes. And I even wrote an article about this experience, because so many women, I'll tell you, are so freaked out. And I'm saying women who don't end up with any kind of breast cancer, still we freak out every year. And so I know that will come up again, but I know now I have a tool. And for whatever else comes up, anything in life, whether it's medical or trying to figure out my next career move, you know, anything.
What you said is so important, because it is stressful every year. Sometimes it's so stressful that women don't go in for their yearly mammogram.
Exactly.
They feel something scary, and they go into denial, and they won't go in for the mammogram because they're afraid of, part of it is waiting for the results. What would you say to those women?
I mean, it is, at least it's all about waiting for the results. That's the scary part. I would say definitely, I mean, obviously go and get your mammogram. But I don't want to tell people they don't need to stress about it, but the statistics are in our favor of nothing's going to be wrong, but we have to find a way. And I would recommend hypnotherapy. I have told friends, when I've talked to women about this, I ask them, do you feel like this? And they say, oh, every year. So we can't put ourselves through this stress every year. It's so unhealthy in itself, right? It works against us.
Yes, and you would recommend hypnotherapy, but what would you recommend with seeing Giannina?
Well, I would say definitely to go to her and go and have the hypnotherapy session so that you have a tool to work with, so you don't have to put yourself through this kind of agony every year. And like I said, it's every year. So we have to find a way, and we want to have a quality of life.
You know, since it right? is every year, I want to ask Giannina, what other thing do you use in hypnosis?
I have the client connect with a feeling of gratitude.
Gratitude, tell me about that.
Because we live in an amazing age where medical testing has come a long way to help promote our health. It is a little nerve-wracking at times, but at the end of it all, it helps clients and people just be healthier.
I agree. Well, you know what? We're coming to the end of our time together. And I know that everybody is going to want to see Giannina Casarino for her unique way of hypnotherapy. Now, do you Skype or do you only see clients here locally in the greater Los Angeles area?
No, I do Skype and phone sessions, and I see clients here in LA.
Perfect. And you can reach Giannina Casarino at hmigrads.com. It appears we're out of time for today. I want to thank Giannina. I want to thank Tracy for coming in and sharing that very intimate and really brave story. And thank you for the articles that you write to inspire other women. And thank you for telling us how hypnotherapy has helped mind and body. I want to thank everybody in the studio audience and those of you watching at home. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I hope you'll join us next time when we meet more people and explore how they are using hypnosis today. But please stay tuned. We have a lot more coming up for you on Hypnosis TV.